Yes, indeed, and that will get some attention, won't it? Yes, DJT, and you probably know who that is, was right when he said, "It's about the deal." Now, what could that mean? It truly is about the deal, and he was right. And is there a Jesus deal? Well, there just might be. My name is Stan Houston. The program is called The Jesus Entrepreneur Experience, and this is Friday, the 3rd of May, and the program begins right now.
Come and listen in to the radio station, where the mighty host of heaven sings.
And indeed, welcome back. Yes, today is my Karen's birthday, and I won't tell you how many birthdays she has had, but she's had quite a few, as have I too. And the little card that I got her simply summarized some deep thoughts, and it was one of those things in a dollar store gift card. I found this wonderful birthday card, and it just said something about, "I cannot believe how amazing and unique you are." And that was so wonderfully true that in the many years that I have known this wonderful woman, I have been surprised as she gets older how much more amazing and unique she has become, and how much wiser and kinder and gracious she has become, even though she was wonderful to begin with. Oftentimes I've said, hopefully not in a negative way, that most of the really interesting people I've met are not young. Well, there are young people who have interests, and they certainly have some experiences, and they can be interesting. But usually the truly interesting people are people with stars and scars and many yars, many years. And they have the stories to tell, the wisdom to share, and sometimes they can actually help us do. What we talked about last week is, you know, when pain comes into our life, and it will come, and it does come, and in fact, it is in your life right now, we can either use it to be transformed, be changed, or we probably will simply pass it on. And how much trouble there is in the world because people didn't transform the pain or let it transform them. They just passed it on to others. And as the old expression says, and the beat goes on. Hey, my dear daughter, Megan, who is a book editor and a writer, and I've always kind of admired her. In fact, she wrote a book that we're going to talk about. It's a wonderful title because many of you know that I've actually produced a program and will be creating one right now, more up to date, about how to help young people start their career and find their first job. Start their career and find their first job. And she wrote a book called How to Be Useful. Wonderful little book. And she did extremely well with it. And what she discovered was that, you know, she's clever. She's cute. She's creative. She's a little bit crafty. I mean, she had the whole works. But what she discovered was that none of that stuff was terribly important in the marketplace. What was important was how useful could she be for other people? How can you be useful? Well, that's a long way of getting to what she told me one time because she's a New Yorker. Right after college, she literally packed up all of her stuff and left Minneapolis and with a Ryder truck along with a friend, said if you can make it in New York, you can make it anywhere, and I want to be a writer and a publisher, and the action is in New York. And so off she went, and that's actually where she has spent the last 20-some years as a true New Yorker writer and editor. And as a result of that, she usually begins things with a New York expression, which is, here's the deal. Here's the deal. Dad, here's the deal. And what she is doing is describing the situation and the things and the options that perhaps we should do about the situation. Or perhaps here are some options for you in the situation. Dad, here's the deal. Well, I think all of you now know that I've probably got myself in a little bit of trouble because you figured out that what I was really saying, what DJT is, that is Donald J. Trump. Obviously, everybody has an opinion, and it's probably pretty well divided. As someone once said to me, when my daughter gave me a book on how to find an editor for your book, the editor said, and came right back to me, Stan, do you want people to like your book? And she said, and I said, well, yes. And she says, no, you don't. You want people to either love it or hate it. You don't just want them to like it. Well, you just think about that. Well, that expression, here's the deal. And Donald J. Trump, you probably either like him or you hate him, one or the other. He certainly, and by the way, that is very much a part of his style. Now, the thing I told people, because as soon as I heard about Donald Trump running for office about 3 or 4 years ago, I had known about him before because, actually, he's obviously a celebrity. Plus the fact that in the book, How to Be Useful, my daughter talks about 10 people. And the last one she talked about, you guessed it, was the man from New York himself, Donald Trump. And this was long before any aspirations to be president, and the analysis, as she said, was very fair, in some respects positive, and in some respects, obviously, there are things that, like everybody else, you know, probably there's some improvement that could be noted and perhaps worked on. But when I found that out, I went back and I read about Trump. And as I point out, hey, what he did is before the age of 40, he wrote his first book. And it was called The Art of the Deal. The Art of the Deal. And it became a bestseller. And then he used that. And what he did is he turned his business of real estate development, certainly nothing very enticing or creative, and he turned it into a personal brand. And so it became the Trump Tower. It became the Trump Deal, the Trump Thing. And it was not only his ability to do real estate deals and development, it was his ability to make the market, how to market himself, the services and the products and the places that he owned. So I read that, and you will not understand a lot of Donald Trump, and I would say probably 90% of the media that is out there one way or the other has never figured out that the man took very seriously the art of the deal. And what I would like to do in just the few minutes left on this Friday flowing into the weekend, can I just suggest that he got it right? I'm Stan Houston. Please reach out to me at RadioEdge77@gmail.com. radioedge77@gmail.com, radioedge77@gmail.com. I would be grateful if you'd check out our place and stage, tcenglobal.org, tcenglobal.org. And if you would do .org/contribute now and help support the work we do as Jesus entrepreneurs, I would be grateful. In fact, that's part of the deal I'd like to make. We'll be right back. Now, obviously, I have some of you a little bit concerned, and I have some of you upset, and some of you have left. Because, first of all, you may not like the fact that I have mentioned Trump, and that whole idea of the deal, deal maker, make a deal, it kind of has some bad implications to many of us. You know, what is that all about? Now let me try and see if I can put it into a context. Rightly or wrongly, based on his experience, Trump came to believe that most of life is a deal. And you don't make bad deals. You get them, but you don't try and make them. You try and make good deals. And we are continually in our life and our business, we are making deals. And in fact, even a relationship can be a deal. Maybe my wife Karen and I have a deal. It's an agreement. It's a relationship. It's a commitment. And I have certain responsibilities and opportunities, and she certainly has certain responsibilities and opportunities. And it's when the deal goes bad that life goes bad. It is when someone deals us something that's bad to us and we don't know how to deal with it. It's when we are hoping that the deal meant this and it turned out to mean something else. But to understand Trump, he is in the business, whether it's with the Chinese in trade, whether it's with the immigration issue with Mexico and Central America, whether it is working with his political opponents and his competitors and even his enemies, he's committed to the fact that you try and see if you can make a deal. And every deal will be imperfect, but it will be a deal that perhaps you could make the best of. I'm just going to ask you to take that thought seriously, because you're a Christian entrepreneur and you are in the business of getting up every day and trying to make a deal. A deal that is good for you, for your family, hopefully for the kingdom of God. A deal that'll make Jesus perhaps smile, and one that will serve the community and serve the common good and maybe even the kingdom of God. One of our deals is to try and raise technology and money to save the lives of hungry children. Do you know that one child dies of hunger every 3.6 seconds? That's part of our deal. And so if this business, this enterprise called the Christian Entrepreneur Network can succeed, part of the deal is that we will try to make Jesus smile by dealing with the issue of childhood hunger around the world. So, in effect, maybe there's more to this idea of the deal than we give it credit for. But may I just ask you to take just a moment and let this sit on your head for a while. And perhaps in that old expression of Rod Serling, the Twilight Zone, not only let it sit on your head, but for your thought and consideration. I oftentimes have come to the conclusion that Jesus is here, And he has a bit of a deal. Follow me. That's the deal. And we say, well, why should we do that? And he said, if you do, there will be things good for you. And there will be hard things. The journey will be difficult. But you will be fully alive forever. You will experience my presence, and you will experience my power. And number three, you'll be able to deal with the deals. Yes, deal with the deals. When I signed up for all the things that come with life, I didn't sign up for bad stage cancer. But that's part of my deal. I didn't sign up for the realization that my dear daughter was going to be in a domestic violence situation. But that became part of my deal. I didn't sign up for people who said, I will take care of you and I will really help you in your life and business, and then I will betray you. But that was part of the deal I got. And what I'm saying is, all of us, and we even use the expression, don't we? Well, you have to play the cards you were dealt. They came to you. What Jesus is in the business of is, with his power, with his presence, to reach in and bring us into forever eternal life. And in the meantime, I will be with you. I will work with you. I will help you make the right deals, make the right choices, help you make the things that will be good for you, your family, and the community of God and the community of all. I'll help you make good deals, and I'll help you deal with the deals. And in the end, at close of business, it will be good. It will be good. It will be a really good deal. I don't know if today has touched you in any way. I hope it may have helped you and touched your heart. But it's something I had to say today because I'm looking for the Lord Jesus to help me deal with a bunch of difficult deals. And so my prayer as I start this weekend and as I start it with you is, Lord, be with me. Be with my dear wife, Karen. Be with my children. And be with all of my friends who are connected to me now, and help us. Give us the power and the presence and the forever love of your person, and help us deal with the deals. I'm Stan Houston. We would be grateful if you could help us. TCENGlobal.org/contribute now. TCENGlobal.org/contribute now. I coach, I teach, I connect. I believe God has gifted me with the ability to help you in your business. So why don't you simply answer this question? I'm Stan. How can I help you? I would be grateful for the opportunity. All the best and blessings. May the weekend go well for you. Please do what you were made for. You were made to worship. And that will profoundly help you deal with the Monday that is to come. All the best and blessings, and as the good Lord loved to say in his resurrection time, peace be with you.